Another thing that's effective is if you have the student play the two twice, that two can't repeat unless you stop on it the first time. So I'll very often coach someone to stop on, to play the two twice, and then once that is felt, to substitute the thumb for the last two. If you start talking about a double rotation, the tendency usually is for people to make the rotation too large as they go from the two to the one. They're trying to do what you've asked them to do, but it's very easy to make the rotation too big, particularly in any kind of speed. So another cue that I find useful is make the thumb have its own movement, or let the thumb have its own movement. That way you don't have to get tangled up in the mechanics of the rotation, but you can feel like the two had a movement, and then separately the thumb had a movement.